Here's how to import a Spriter project into Construct 2. The first thing you'll want to do is choose File, Other File Actions, Custom Save Options in Spriter's menu and make sure all of the custom save options are checked on. Then you'll need to save or export your Spriter project in a specific way depending on which of the two possible Spriter modes you decide upon. The first mode uses multiple standard construct sprites to recreate your animations. This is especially useful if you want to apply independent shader effects to specific portions of your animated object. To import in this mode, save your Spriter project out in both SCML and SCON format with the same exact name. Then drag either the resulting .scon or .scml file directly into your desired layout in C2. Choose either the event sheet for that layout or an event sheet that is included in the layout's event sheet, and then click OK. Once C2 finishes the import process, if you run the frame, you should see your Spriter object playing its first animation. The second Spriter mode option is called Draw Self and does not use standard construct sprites at all. In this mode, you can't apply different effects to specific parts, but you can apply an effect over the entire object. This method is also better for game performance. It's important to know that if your Spriter project includes collision boxes, then even if you want to use the Draw Self method, you must first import the Spriter project in the normal mode so that it can properly generate the collision rectangle sprites in C2. Then manually convert it from within C2 to the Draw Self mode. We'll show this process in an upcoming video. If your project does not include collision rectangles, then you can directly import it in the Draw Self mode. Here's how. This mode does require one more setup step in Spriter before export, and that's to make sure the animations have proper bounding boxes set up, which will make sure that your Spriter object doesn't disappear near the edge of the game window. To do so, select the first animation and then click the small icon to bring up the custom trimming dialog. Select the Calculate Bounding Box from Frames option and choose to perform this process to either just the one animation, all animations in the currently selected entity, or all animations in all entities, then click Apply. Spriter will then create a custom bounding box for each animation based on its actual frames sizes. In Spriter, choose File, Generate Sprite Sheets for Project Images. Make sure Save as SCON and Save Sprite Sheeted Project are checked on, and click the small button with three dots to choose the base file name. Create a new folder to save to, enter the desired name for your Spriter object, click Save, and then click OK. Now find the folder you just created and you'll see it contains several files in a sounds subfolder if your Spriter project included sounds. Go back to Construct 2 and create an SCML object in the desired layout. Load in the PNG image that the export process had created and close the frame editor. Right-click on the Files folder and choose Add Subfolder and create a folder called Spriter Files. Right-click on the folder you just created and choose Import Files and select the .scon file that your export process had created. Select the SCML object in the layout canvas and in its properties set SCML file to the exact name of the .scon file you just imported, being sure to type .scon and not .scml. Set Draw Self to true. Now when you run the layout, the Spriter object should be visible with its first animation playing. If your Spriter project includes sounds, you'll have to import them. Right-click the Sounds folder in the project window and choose Import Sounds. Navigate to the Sounds folder in your Spriter Project folder and select all the sound files and click Import. Go to the same event sheet you chose when importing the Spriter object and add this new event. Sounds, Unsound Triggered, and for the action choose the Audio Object, Play by Name, and in the Audio File Name slot choose your Spriter SCML object, Sounds, Triggered Sound. Now when you play the layout, any sound should be triggered just as you had set them in Spriter. If you go to the event sheet, you'll see that your Spriter object has events and actions very similar to a normal construct sprite. Upcoming videos will cover how to control your Spriter object in detail. Thanks very much for watching.